I put it all together. So you're saying the smoked snake tracks were actually caused by two men dragging a bunch of quicklime?
おそらく市内に限定して、ここ最近の生石灰の売買記録を確かめさせたわ。すると、ある農家が何ヶ月か前に大量の生石灰を購入していたことが分かった。目的は土壌改良。ところが発注ミスによって本来必要とされた量より多くの石灰が搬入されてしまい、農家はその処理に頭を悩ませていたとか。I
have no words. But I came up with an answer quick. So he dumped it illegally?
ごめいと。ちなみに、この風祭り市では土壌改良剤の大量処理は有料。処理に困った農家が明け方に石灰を森に運搬したという線が極めて濃厚だわ。
But he could just send it back.
ソリのようなものに積んで引きずっていったのでしょうね。
And I interpreted as snake tracks.
路中に埋めたところまでは良かったが、水分が侵入してしまったことで袋が膨張、爆発するなどして強度と混ざり、白煙を上げながら高熱を発する巨大な茶色い塊の出来上がりね。
So logical. But why would he drag it through the river if it reacts with water?
運搬人が無知だったか、認識が甘かったのか。
Why didn't it react when he drug it through the river? That doesn't seem right.
現実なんだから、意外とこういうものでしょ?
This seems bullshit. Like dragging chemicals through the water despite knowing they'd react?
危険な行動だとは思うけど、最初から水中に落とすつもりなわけじゃないでしょうし。
Why didn't he just leave it, not past the river?
水路なら移動の手間は軽減できるし、
I see. They were avoiding attention. Damn, our argument has no holes in it.
Well, yeah, it does. よくよく注意して調べていけば、付近に足跡を見つけることはできたはず。歩いた後に重量物を満載したソリが通るのだから、そのほとんどは書き消えていたはずだけれど。
Fine, science once again. Doubt.
この一見、なかなか楽しめたわ。
And identified giant animals aren't that easy to find after all.
巨大生物は望み薄だけれど、深海など未調査地域やごく小さな新種ならまだいるでしょう。Looking
for those would just be more science. There's no way for me to object after hearing all of this. Ah. I think of something. Why not just make this scientific story into an article? There's no rule saying it has to turn out to be a huge UMA. Make it about illegal dumping. Even though it has a scientific explanation, it's still an exciting story. Akana even said it was enjoyable, so in a sense she approves it. Of course.
どうしたの?
Nothing. Akana continued putting her PC together during that conversation. All she had to do was put the old graphics board back in, so it didn't take long. Okay, thanks. I spent an hour rewriting the article. I read it over, and compared to the vague conclusion I had before, this feels much tighter. I try sending it to Tara again. I get a call right away. Approved! Yay! You work fast, that's pretty interesting. Your advice helped. Ah, haha. You want your money tonight? Since it's your first time, we're pretty flexible. I glance over at Akane. She's busy testing her machine. I answer in a low voice. I would love that. And come over here, I'll get it ready. I'll be right over. And then I get shot. Because I know too much. I have money! I thoroughly enjoyed the satisfaction of holding my first job payment in my hand. All I have to do is to get money is write good articles. I like this. Simple, easy to understand, beautiful. And it's a decent sum too. Come to think of it, I did spend all Sunday doing something a little dangerous and got a text and pictures out of it, so this makes sense. Enjoying it helped a lot. Maybe it's a lot of work, but this is my kind of job. Money makes everything easier. My dad told me the successful men always carry their ages times 1,000 yen in their wallets. But even 3 months of allowance wasn't enough to make that happen. A truly meaningless piece of advice. I'll never be successful that way. And now things have changed. So now I can splurge on some yakiniku and still qualify as a successful man. I like this. I want to reek him money someday. The envelope disappears from my hand. What? Akane's secretary is holding my pay envelope. Goodbye. She runs off. What? Give that back! We race through the night. That's my money! I call Akane while chasing her. What the hell is your secretary doing? But I wrote that article. She has a point. Shut up! That's the oldest meme in the book. Damn it, I'm gonna catch up to her. Perfect! And the call and speed up. I pay close attention to the pedestrians as I accelerate. The distance between me and the secretary gradually closes. Stop! Secretary gets taxi. Drives off immediately. Damn you! Even if I can't catch up to a car. At least not directly. Shortcut! I leap into an alley. It's a slum. Cutting through there should save some time. Hey, what's your problem? Yasha! Wah! I kick them aside again. I can't stop. Apparently anyone I get to feed automatically turns into a lamester. Nice and systematic. Who are you? Ah! You don't know who you're dealing with. Ah! Hey! I kick aside several people and rename them as I pass through the alleys. It took a while, but I managed to get to the other side without running out of breath. I emerge from the alleys just as the taxi stops. Secretary's getting out. Give me my money! I grab her shoulders. Secretary smiles. She has one last trick up her sleeve. Before I can react. No! Don't rape me! What? Hands in the air! The power of the state. Throw away your lust right this instant. The lust isn't a physical weapon. Ah! Secretary runs away. You're coming to the station. Damn it! That was terrible. They held me for 30 minutes, but then released me without even an interrogation. Connie must have put in a good word for me. Of course, the secretary is long gone. Press! I call her angrily. What's wrong? So when was there a membership fee? You never said anything about that? She hangs up on me. She actually did seem busy this time. What happened? She said later, but it's already nighttime. Going all the way back to the club room to wait for her doesn't feel worthwhile right now. I don't like leaving her with my money, but for now it seems better to just go home. As I stand there, a patrol car brushes by. It did seem like there weren't many officers in the station. Something big's happening in the city tonight. That's the impression I'm getting. My problem feels small in comparison, making even me more tired. I should go home. Some housewives were chatting on the side of the road. But wasn't it a crime? So many police showed up. But the news didn't even mention it at all. It's still strange. You think there's a media blackout? Why? Maybe they haven't caught the guy yet. Who reported it anyway? Tajima's wife. Her. How did she notice it? She cleans her garden every morning and apparently she stopped a couple of days ago. I'm impressed she had the nerve to report it. It's like a voyeur or something. It worked out fine this time. There wasn't even a smell. Is it supposed to smell? Of course, it's a living thing after all. A long time ago, I lived in a two-room apartment. The old man in their room died, but no one visited him, so he was just left there for a month. The smell was incredible. Oh, one of my relatives died too. Melted in the bath, no less. Melted? He had a heart attack in there. As time passed, it became ghastly. Oh, there should really be a service that checks on these people. Oh, welfare already offers that, but old people who live alone are too proud to sign up. So no one applies. And no one checks up on them. They do have to enter their homes to do that, so... What do you think Tasaki will do about it? Skip it! What else could he do? Or have one of his relatives take it? Don't say that, his family's... Oh, you're right, I'm sorry. What is it? The Tasakis both passed away. Until their bodies look mummified and don't smell at all. I couldn't understand most of what the housewife said. After walking for a while, I passed by a house whose nameplate says Tasaki and it hits me. This house feels abandoned. You obtain info, mysterious deaths. I'm trying to tell you. She gives me a dubious look as I rephrase myself. It's been a mysterious death.
いつ?どこで?
Yesterday, in my neighborhood. The cult club lives off stories like this. And this one jumped right out to me today. So I gathered everyone up as soon as lunch break hit and told them about it. I don't know many details either. Know anything that might help? Pretty sure. The victims were the Tasakis. I've heard a similar story at school, did it, too. One of my friends asked me this once. Hey, is it true someone died in the house next to yours? I don't have much information on it either. But I do have reasons to believe something strange happened. The police seemed busy yesterday. Prez, were they helping you with something? What do you mean you didn't go that far? My money returns to the rightful owner. It's all here, what happened to the membership fee? Seems more like torturing me than joking. You're evil. Just something I heard people talking about. Do you know Tasaki? Ah, you do know her. I'm pretty sure that's the one. Apparently she and her husband both met a bizarre and untimely end. I love you. Your life must be so peaceful, Chihaya. I was being sarcastic. I see. Death is a pretty touchy subject. I get just as mad as anyone else when I see murder reports that make the victim's death seem so mundane. I guess you're right. Even I have to agree on this one. This is too serious for us. I figured passing up something like that would be a bad idea for an occult club, but yeah, we shouldn't. You threw away info mysterious deaths. Now our club will be respectable. Though I'd still like to know how someone can get mummified by dying in their own home. You've got a point. And there's only one place that fulfills that condition. Outer space. Okay, how about the
fringe?
You're making it sound like any body of you would mummify if it was buried underground.
So, you're not going to be able to do it.
水中の死体って腐らないんですか？
低温湿潤の環境では変化した脂肪が化学的に安定してしまい、老人魚のようになって半永久化することがあるの。美しい死体になってよ。
Scary。
ただ自宅内で亡くなったのならどちらも考えにくいわね。あるとすればミイラ化だけど、よほど室内が乾燥し通気性が良くなければ。
乾燥機がつけっぱだったのかも。
How long does it take to mummify after dying?
最低でも数ヶ月。
じゃあデマだ。その奥さん最近まで普通に生きてたから。
映画で吸血鬼に血を吸われて短期間でミイラになった。
体内の水分が何らかの理由で急速に失われた状態であれば、ミイラ化までの時間は短縮されるでしょうね。
We should investigate this. This is getting interesting.
ダメだよ。探り入れたら。
I'm prying into it. I know.
タロ、このネタあげる。
You obtained info of the Seven Wonders, Red Boy. Where do you get this?
道で拾った。
Loot! Are rumors really that easy to find?
元気を出してほしい。
Thank you, Chizuru. You're such a good girl. I want to know more about this murder.Give me that info. Hey, Katori. Oh, skipping days now. You obtained info. I saw Rainbow Paradise down the Tsumugi River. You obtained info. Another world appearing near the Tsumugi River. So we have these hot leads now. I got from the blog. For once, someone submitted something useful. Now look at the club members gathered here. What do you think?
同じ川。
So blunt. Did you notice anything else they had in common? Shizuru, how what about you? Shizuru thinks for a moment. She gasps. What is it?
名前が似ている。
They're the same river. Katori already said that. How does your brain even work?
残念ながら見たことないからよくわからない。
If you ever saw it, you'd probably be dead. Okay, class rep, tell us what else they have in common.
川以外の共通点は一つしかない。川だ。
If you're gonna play dumb, at least do it plausibly. Look at me when I'm talking. Damn it, these girls. I'm gonna ban cosmetics.
Lip cream は cosme には入らないよな。
Yes, it does. It so does.
嫌がらせか。もし唇が乾いたらどうするつもりだ。
That's not the point. Jihaya, please.
私も川ネタ言わないといけないんです。
Or you could give the correct answer.She wasn't paying attention at all. Okay, fine, I'll say it. These two leads sound really similar. Don't they both say something otherworldly going on near this river? Presumably, it's a place near the river that looks weird. Maybe it has its own miniature ecosystem.
それで異世界なんですか？
バクとした話だ。大体、ここに来る当初はいい加減なネタが多すぎるんだ。
That's what happens when you ask the internet for help. I'm just hoping for something article worthy, so it doesn't matter if there's an actual paradise or whatever. The problem is we have too few leads.
Oh, 本音出た。
場所はどのあたりなの？
Akane's been typing away at her computer the whole time, but now she raises her head. I don't know, both submissions were a mere rumor. But that should make it more fun to investigate.So for our next weekend quest, I'd like to investigate this.
またピクニックか。いいけど。
ほとんどピクニック研究会だな。
Doesn't matter, we're all having fun.
またしんどそうですね。
Now let's decide who's coming. Raise your hand if you want in.
パス。
パスかな？
パスで。
意表ついてパスだ。
You're all coming. I roar.Every last one of you.
練習の実践を尊重しすぎるのは下策ね。
It would if some of you were more cooperative. So it's been decided everyone will forcibly participate.
明日か。用事あったのにな。
Not anymore.
森歩きなんてごめんだわ。
It's not the forest, we're walking through a river.
無駄足確定だからな、しかも。
昨夜連れて行こうかな。
代理に犬とかじゃダメ？
No. The girls are all complaining. Shizuru was preparing a mountaineering backpack, so she's even unsure what to do now. Thank you, Shizuru. You're the only good soul in this club. I get that doing nothing, but field work is tough for girls, but... She reveals her true colors. They hurt me. Tomorrow after school, we go on a quest. Don't plan anything. Got it? We're not going on a quest, are we? Or at least we won't find anything good. After school lets out, we all eat in a symbol in the park. While I double-check the route we'll be using today, the girls begin their usual chatter.
Oyatsu, nani motte kita? Watashi wa Ame-chan. Shio senpei desu!
Oh my god, it's really cute though.
Amanatto.
Is that a soup?
Saichu. Saichu.
I wanna ask too, but checking the map is more important.
Sassuru tokoro, saichan kana? Taberareru desu, sore.
It can?
Nara, nagamari maichu kana? Chewing candy no.
Taberareru desu sore.
Kibishii ga. Nantoka naru.
There's nothing difficult about it.
Kaichu kana?
Taberareru desu sore.
Kibishii ga. Nantoka naru.
Don't do it. No.
One, two.
That would be a major scientific breakthrough. After watching that incredibly pointless series of questions and answers, Katori pulls an economy-sized bag out of her backpack. Lucia reads the package.
Monanka.
Ah, naruhodo. Ato de oyatsu koukan shiyou. Wakekko shiyou.
They all get excited about the trip. Such chatty girls. I finally finished checking the map. For some reason, I feel a sense of unity from them. It's not like we hate each other or anything. But it feels like I'm the only one wasting energy. Is this what I get for being the only boy here? Do we need another one in the club? I only know one person who'd fit the bill, but he loves the idea. Ugh. As I feel alienated, I looked at Akane. She also seems a bit isolated. She's supposed to be the boss. Actually, that might be because she is the boss. She acts arrogant around me, but she also tends to retreat a little around that group of girls. We all find satisfaction in seeing Akane's weakness. Akane suddenly starts looking around. She sensed that? That's way too precise. Prez, you got a minute? Leaving her alone is dangerous. Long strange stragglers like that is bad for the occult club. Can you check the route I came up with? She looks over the plan drawn on the map. Well, I picked up a few things on it from books and the internet. Relying on my cell phone seems like a bad idea if we ever got lost seriously lost. So I'd been looking up a few things about real maps from time to time. It took barely any effort to learn. Maybe I'm good at this. I'm more of a Boy Scout than you think. Coincidentally, she flares. Some flares fall out of Akane's pocket. You very obviously don't trust me. Though it's good to be careful in these situations. Anyway, I know how to survive without relying on my cell phone. So don't worry and focus on leading everyone.
とても面倒だけれど、川歩きだとでも思うことにするわ。
Good enough. Hey, I think we should get going now. I yell toward Kotori and the others as they sit down on the grass. Now let's begin the search. Goody, time to run through the forest. That's a tall tree. Must have been here a long time. Okay, let's see. Use Chihaya's chainsaw to find out how old it is. Oh, there's pretty flowers here.
この辺は日当たりもいいから、ツツジは花の根元を吸うと甘い。
More survival trivia. Yeah, but we'll kill you. Sort of question. Pushing forward. After following the map for a short while, we reach a river. We're still in a picnic territory at the moment.
綺麗な川。
The water is clear and sparkling. Katori dips her hand into it and brings it to her mouth.
おやめなさい。よすんだ。
To the two of the other stopper.
どうしたの？
川の水は直に飲まない方がいい。
Hey, you don't know what the fuck's in it.
お腹を壊すぞ。
これでもお腹は丈夫なんだよ。
水は自前のものを飲みなさい。
はい。
God, Katori.